Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will continue exploring how the copy-paste feature can help you save a lot of time while using RoboDK, and we'll also show you how you can modify the generic home position of any robot. Let's get started. So here we are with the same station we've been using for the last few videos, here with our robot, laser head, and our part. Let's do something real quick. So if I open the robot panel, you see here we have all the values for either the tool position, the frame position, or the tool with respect to the frame position. As you know, those are divided in six different or distinct values. So X, Y, Z, and then a rotation around the different axes. For now, if you wanted to copy information from one of these targets or of these text box to another one, you had to literally copy and paste those manually one by one from one spot to the other. So let's say I'm going to create a bit of a dumb situation where I have a target. I'm just going to position it somewhere that doesn't make sense so that you can kind of see what's going on right here. Okay, perfect. So this is my target one. Remove this one here. Perfect. And if I press F3, I don't want to go there. Bring back the robot to its own position. And if I press F3, I have my target panel. So if I wanted to have the robot, let's say, or the target at this specific point, forget about the T-screen position, this kind of another shortcut. But let's say that I want these values to go here. I had to go and enter them manually, blah, blah, blah. That would take a bit of time and I prefer a faster solution. So here, as you can see, we have copy and paste buttons. Those will apply to the text boxes that are the closest. So if I copy here the value, it will copy those six values. And if I click here, paste, it will apply those six values. So now I needed to make sure that I have that with respect to the same frame. So here, so copy and then paste. So now it moved target one where my tool was positioned. Like I said, I could have reached the same exact result by simply clicking teach current position, but here it was to show you what you could do with that. So I could also decide to create a frame. I make it a child of the robot frame, and then I can simply press paste. And now the frame, even if you don't see it, is right here at the same exact spot. So that's very cool. Another thing that you need to know is when you're copying those values, you're not copying really X, Y, Z, and then the rotation. If I open a notepad and I press Control V, it's the 4x4 matrix representing the robot rotation. In fact, here you have the 3x3 matrix representing the robot rotation, and you have here X, Y, and Z. So this is the general method of how a pause, so position and orientation, is represented mathematically speaking in the background of RoboDK and in robotics in general. I will most likely do in the future a video explaining how this works exactly, but that's a bit out of the scope of RoboDK's usage in general. It's more of a robotic thing, but I will kind of touch on it. So that's how the position is recorded in the background. If I go here and I click on the little three bars, I also have the possibility to copy just the values. So I could click copy values and then paste the values. And now I will have just these ones here. I could go ahead and copy the pause. So this is what we do here, cut the pause here, paste values or pause. That would also work. Then you have invert pose. So this one is interesting. We have no use for it in the current setup, but I will use it for sure later. when it's time to accurately position object in the station, because I showed you earlier how to position object in the station, but that kind of required you to know where the object were supposed to go. There's ways with RoboDK to kind of measure stuff around and therefore extract translation or reorientation. So that will be you. Invert pause will be useful. So the way invert pause works, it's kind of like if you have the path to go from point A to point B, but if you want to have the path from point B to point A instead, you need to invert the path from point A to point B. So it will invert the pause. So let's say if you are, if point B is at 100.00 with respect to the point A, then point A is at -100.00 with respect to point B. So that's how that's what it does. It's super useful, but I'm going to show you exactly where and why in the future. You can do exactly the same also with robot joint position. So if you click here, copy on the joint values, and I bring back Notepad and Control V, you will have a set of six joint values here. So that's cool. What you can do with that, you can obviously copy the joint values, which is always useful. But let's say that I want my home position to always be like that if I right click and go home, or if I click home here. How can I do that? Easy. You bring your robot to the position or the orientation that you want, or joint configuration in fact that you want. So let's go for 0, 15, minus 15, 0, and then 35. Completely random, but I like it. I'm gonna click copy here on the joint axis jog, and I'm gonna go for parameters. If you don't own a RoboDK professional license or a fully unlocked trial, you won't have access to this window here, but for all the others, you will. So once you are in parameters, you can click on set home position. Here you have 0, 0, 0. This was the home position by default. You can click paste. It will go 0, 15, minus 15, 0, 35. Same as here. If I click OK, I'm here. Let's go here, let's say. And now if I click on home, it will go to that newly registered position. So that can be useful in certain situations where the generic home position doesn't make sense. And you would like to have something a bit more custom, you can do it right away like that. Okay, that's pretty much everything for this video and for this module. The only thing left we have is a small bonus example that I'm going to explain you in the next video. Apart from that, we're done for this module. In module 3, we will start exploring how to do pick and place application using RoboDK. So that's going to be very fun. Hope to see you there and have a great day, guys.